I'm black child. No, I don't know. What do you write?
Wait, who?
She's Sandy? Okay, we'll come back to you. So while we wait for Nama, we're going to have some background music, and then we'll come right back, all right?
I am special, ready for my swinging. I am strong, obstacles cannot stop me. I hold my head up high, proudly proclaim my uniqueness. I am proud of my heritage. I am confident that I can achieve my every goal. I am a black child, I am a child of God.
Give another round of applause for Nama. Well, with that being said, let's see. We do have I Am by the youth of Siloe. So while they're coming up to do that, I Am, let's see. So, I know we're all proud to be black. But I want to know from the Glamour, from the older folks. Can one of you guys come up and tell us what it was like? Give it up for Mikano, everyone. Give it up for Mikano. Good evening. Bonsoir, tout le monde. Grandi dans un pays qui est encore ici, peut avoir une boutique de mots, pour pas avoir joué nous chers. Et faut avoir mangé, mangé, rire. Un petit peu de merci pour mémoire qui est capable de faire changer et aussi de tels souvenirs d'enfance que j'ai vécu dans. Puis en Haïti, je me suis dit que il y a une plus belle souvenir d'enfance, c'est parce que moi, je vais faire la vie, je fais un côté qui est tout le monde est beau de la limonade. Ça veut dire qu'on va faire une petite minute pour. Ça peut être une petite minute de votre mère pour aller travailler ici. Ça veut dire que j'ai une chance pour me capable. Simone, la pluie a tombé, il sorti dans la rue, il a couru. Il y a une chance pour me capable de voir si a vu ma reine. Il y a une chance pour me capable de voir si mon a fait la go cachée et la go vibrée. Il songeait que le navire, le mari, l'école, la ville, côté que nous qu'on a marché par des missions de prendre machine pour aller à l'école. Quel que soit votre dérive, il était 10-15 miles à marcher. Si l'oxygène est trop loin, ou qu'il y a un bicyclette ou aller, je pense que c'est une raison qui fait que nous avons vu plus longtemps. Parce que marcher a été un exercice pour nous. Mais quand on est là, c'est juste n'importe quel côté où on peut aller, c'est une motocyclette. Je pense qu'il faut être capable de penser. On sait que le bagage que nous avons fait, pour nous-mêmes, c'est punition, mais c'était un exercice que nous avons. Je songeais que pendant que l'école, l'éducation était un petit différent parce que par un, pour lui-même, pour faire un bon job avec les filles, c'est chaque chose fait, c'est calo. Si on va faire bon bagage, c'est calo. Je n'ai pas de chance pour me lever dans le foyer, pour dire que par un marché de la balade, si je dis à mes chances, il y a Simon Moin, sans que je ne pas jouer dans le jeu, je transmets à Simon Moin. Nous avons un bon souvenir d'enfance que Assoué n'a pas suffi pour capable de nous, mais vraiment fier de ce que nous sommes dans le pays qui est en Haïti. Well, I can say for myself I wasn't born in Haiti, but I've been to Haiti twice in my life and I can say the both times I went. They were both beautiful experiences, and I can't wait to go back. And one thing I love about being Haitian, more than anything else in the world, is the food. I like on TV, you know how that sauce fly. I like on leg, you need to talk. Yes! I love me some good Haitian food. I love kibbeh, I love chicken, I love kabri. Yes, and Haitian food is the best food. I'm not like the other beasts. Haitians always make the best food, I can say that. So, with that being said, I am the youth of Siloe. Are they ready? Let's give a round of applause for the youth of Siloe and their skit, I Am.
Which talked about the lynching of black people, which you would know the white folks hated me singing, and I received warnings from many U.S. government federals, but that didn't stop me from speaking up for my people. I am Billie Holiday.
In the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise.
Does my sassiness offend you? Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries. Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it off of heart? Cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words, and you may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I rise. I rise up from a past that's lifted in pain. I rise. I am a black ocean, leaping and wide, bringing in the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slaves. I rise, I rise, I rise.
My whole life, I was known as the sick child. From being born prematurely, having scarlet fever, polio, pneumonia twice, and problems with my left leg. It was an impossible journey for me, but I didn't let that stop me. Can I get an amen? Amen. So I trained, and I worked hard, and I became known as the world record Olympic champion and the international sports icon for track and field. I am Wilma Rudolph.
With black people. Then I realized Elijah Muhammad was foolish. Elijah Muhammad was doing things more like a hypocrite would be doing. So I left the Nation of Islam. And I was banned from the Nation of Islam as well, but eventually I still stood firm on black people. I still stood firm that black people should be united. Then I went to Mecca. When I went to Mecca, I realized Islam is not just for black people. Islam is for everyone, black, white, purple, green, short, tall. It doesn't matter who you are, but Allah loves you so much. It doesn't matter the color of your skin. So I came back from Mecca and I decided to start my own belief. But I had the FBI watching me for so many years. I had the FBI trying to kill me. I had the FBI trying to bomb my house with my children inside. But Allah still watched over us. And then, I remember one night, I had a sermon I had to do. My wife and my three beautiful girls were there. And the last thing I say, may Allah be with you. And I remember 16 bullet shots. And that was it. I am Malcolm X. Yeah. So let's give another round of applause for those beautiful children that just came up. Right about now, we are going to do a dance by the dance team. So give it up one more time for the dance team. And right after the dance team, we have a skit. And then we'll move on from there.
Yeah!
Give it up for him, ladies and gentlemen.
Don't look into my face and see the color of my skin and not the content of my character. Don't look into my history and see the darkness of my past and not the brightness of my future. Don't look at all the losses of my mistakes and not see the profits of my achievements. Don't look at the distance I have yet to travel and not see the origin from which I have come. Don't look at the foolishness of my youth and not see the wisdom of my older age. Don't look at the poverty of my family and not see the riches of its love. Don't look at the child I once was and not see the black man I have become.
Is everyone okay back there? All right. Coming up to the next stop on 19th Street. All right. Beep beep. Wow, oh, this way. Thank you. How you doing? Get to the back. You know your kind, Blackie. Go sit down in the back. All right, we're coming on 19th Avenue. All right, next stop. Oh, Mrs. Wilson, how you doing? How you doing? Ma'am, how you doing? Very lovely. Yes, have a seat, thank you.
I am not yet on the bus. Listen, ma'am, you know your kind. Get to the back of the bus. Stop it. I do not care. I am not getting up. Excuse me, Mr. Bus Driver, sir. I clearly told this African-American Blackie to head to the back, and yet she's still in my seat. Yes, sir.
Ma'am, I'm gonna need you to get up now. All right, Blackie, get up and go to the back of the bus like every other black person on this bus. Listen, I'm gonna tell you one more time or I'm calling the cops. Ma'am, don't worry, Mrs. Wilson, we'll get you seat. Officer!
What's the problem?
This aggressive Negro is not getting to the back of the bus.
It's a Negro? They always doing problems, man.
Always.
Ma'am, get up off this bus now. Okay, you're under arrest.
Mrs. Wilson, are you wrong? Man, what's like that in there? What's like that in there? Mrs. Wilson, is everything okay? All right, trust me, we'll handle this situation really soon. give it up for the youth of Siloe with a praise dance.
Calling me to answer, gonna keep on leaving on.
right now we have a poem by Isyana and Harley.
Oh, they say I'm not the average black girl. Poised full of etiquette of a white man's token. You know, I remember my ex-mother telling me I didn't know how you was gonna react when you brought home a black girl. But I like you because you talk so white. When did me talking right equate to me talking so white? They say I'm not the average black girl.
No, no, not the average black girl, because the pigment of my skin color is a shade lighter than that black girl over there. You know, that black girl over there, the black girl with the nappy hair, whose elbows can't skip a day without lotion, whose heads and hearts are filled with self-hate and bodily emotion. The cocoa brown girl has to face society every day and be tough, because no matter how good they straighten their hair, their good is still not good enough. They say I'm not the average black girl.
Oh, but see, luckily for me, see, I don't fall in that category. Cause you don't want to come off as one of those average black girls and come off as rude.
But see, I get passed because the pigment of my skin color matches that brown paper bag. And my father, brother, and men that I date, pants don't sag. And when I speak, my tongue pronounces every syllable.
They say I'm not the average black girl. Well, let's flip this script, rewrite the script, repaint the lines and have them blurred over time because the average black girl that I know.
See, the average black girl that I know made 19 trips through the Underground Railroad to be slaves. Saw segregated buses, refused to get up, and paid new ways. See, the average black girl that I know.
The average black girl that I know were Egyptian queens who were ruling whole armies and dynasties of men. Excuse me why I set fire to this poem, because I am tired. Tired of stereotype black girls have fallen to because American mentality.
So pardon me if I can openly accept your compliments. Pardon me if I can openly accept your compliments. It's just the average black girl that I know. The average black girl that I know has the courage to surpass it every fear. Fought for justice and equality year after year. So excuse me as I shed tears as I write this poem. Cause the average black girl that I know.
I was not the half black girl she was. See, a minor clause. She was out there fighting, breaking, and changing laws. So I bow down to my black queen standing in the mirror of her work.
I am not the average black girl. I can only aspire to be.
Alright, give it another round of applause for the two of them. Right about now, I want you to give the biggest applause that you can to our one and only Edness, aka Boo, who is going to do a portion of I Have a Dream by MLK. Even though, with the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. This dream is deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day, this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day, my four little children will be able to live in a nation where they are not judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream down here in Alabama, with its vicious racists, with its governor dripping from the lips the words of interposition and nullification. I have a dream that one day little black boys and black girls will be able to hold hands with little white boys and white girls as brothers and sisters. I have a dream today. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Jésus dans leur vie. Pas béni tout petit mot, pas béni l'église, pas béni jeune, pas béni la famille pastorale de l'église. Nous prions dans le nom de Jésus.
Amen.